We've all seen holograms, and what makes it special is its three-dimensional nature, which is much different than a perspective change on a photograph. We call many things holograms, but many are not. For example, many 3D projections, such as when they brought back Michael Jackson, is just an optical illusion where it's a projection of that individual. This is something we call Pepper's ghost. I'm here offering an IAP course here at MIT called Hands-on Holography. We cover geometrical optics, we cover the electromagnetic spectrum, we generate our own optical holograms, as well as audio holograms, and we get into computational holograms as well. A big takeaway from this class is really understanding the wave mechanics of light and the electromagnetic spectrum. If we look at the two words in a hologram, it means whole writing, and we take into account a special nature of light, which we call phase, and record it on a film plate using an interference pattern to recreate an entire scene in its entirety. People think of anything that appears three-dimensional to be a hologram, but if it doesn't contain that phase nature, it is not a hologram. We have individuals ranging from art majors to engineers. We've even had some MIT staff themselves take this course. And we try to really give an intuitive feel for what is going on with holograms and interference patterns in general. I'm an optical engineer. I enjoy the wave nature of light. What makes holography really special is that we're able to extract that phase nature and that extra information and make use of it.